Hello and welcome to my coding session where I'm developing a JavaFX application for managing XML files which are consist of satellite's channel information. And let's quickly change to the Eclipse. Right, so basically I ended my last session of thinking about how I should go further with my set transponder builder test unit class. And the next thing which I should do, so now where I did make sure that I have a proper ranges in my set transponder builder class, I need to think about strange things. I need to think about to do the stuff with my, let me just quickly go to the set transponder builder. Yeah. It was strange problem. So now I need to work it, I need to write a test where I am just make some notes. What should I do? I need to get hold of a JDOM document. And from that I need to get hold of a transponders. And when I'm getting hold of a transponders, I need to check the attributes, and if the attributes valid, I need to assign them to the list. And after doing this, I add transponder, I mean not to the list but to the transponder class object. And after that I need to add a transponder object to a transponder list. This should be pretty interesting. And do not forget about adding channels into the mixture. So I did write the helper class which I use here in my source test Java, and helper utils. Let me just quickly. So this class is a helper class in my unit tests, and here I'm actually look over for a transponder. But I have this situation, some sort of a different type. I just need to look up for my satellite, and when I look up for my satellite, I need to get hold of a transponder. No, when I did look up for satellite, for this one special satellite, that's it. Now I get this JDOM element, which represents information only about one satellite. And then I start to create my transponders. And the result will be the list of transponders for one special satellite. And this is what I'm actually expect from my builder. So set transponder builder, set transponders builder class, it builds I have my models here. So set transponder builder, let me just quickly create a diagram. Set transponder builder, his main function create a list of transponders. List of transponders for one satellite. Let me just quickly. Transponders for one satellite. Now, and it will be like this, and here I represent with T1, T2, and so on the list of my transponders. And I need to test it out. I need to create a test which actually will test it out, so that I'm making sure that I can actually create a list of transponders from my builder. And it can be complex, so let's just think it through. I need get hold of satellite, only one satellite. Let me just create a help util class which throwaway class, read XML, and so basically it creates a JDOM document, and create JDOM with one satellite, and I'm using wrong stuff. So I'm creating this class. And I can reuse the code which I have written here. So what I need to set random carbon XML result, yeah, I can work with that. Read up and set up JDOM document. So it's just throwaway class for the purpose of creating some stuff. So now get path to XML, get path to XML, get path to XML. I just need to save it. This I just forgot to write it now. So it will be kind of ugly at the point, but I just need to get a setter. So basically building the ground. Now let me just get a setter. I'm adding getter set read. Yeah, get a setter for the, all of this. Now check up. Checking up the XML reader status. I need to copy this method. Here you go. Some sort of a boilerplate code, but this is what you get when you work with the XML. But once again, this is not a production code. This is just for my tests, to work with my tests. This is the additional material stuff. So now what I need to do . So I'm basically doing following: read and set up JDOM document, so I'm setting up path to XML, which is services, which is good. And now I need to get hold of, I need to write a method where I am getting hold of F1 special satellite. So basically, yeah, I need such thing. So think I can, let me just think about iterating over. Here I'm iterating over. Here I'm picking up the satellite. Let me just copy this code. Okay, so here I'm picking up the satellite, and let me just look it up, the calling of here. I need to call it up, but I will probably refactor. I will definitely refactor this method. So read JDOM document and create third level element list. Get root, get children set. Not so I don't need this. And I actually need to return back an element which represents a one satellite with a list of transponders and CTV channels in this list. Now here you go. So basically, I need to, let me just write it down. So get hold of JDOM document, get hold of transponders. So in my test, which I will write, I need to call this method up, because I need to set up JDOM document. After doing this, let me just I don't like the null new element, maybe like so, maybe not. Does it have a construct? Is not it's visible. Okay. Okay, it doesn't matter right now. I can leave with null too. As I said earlier, it's not a production code. It's a throwaway class which I need to use for my test. So it does not matter. Let me just close this down. So now I got my satellite. Now I need just to write the order of getting all of this, which I need to. So I need to get this element. Okay, so this is what I'm actually need to work off, and all of these methods belong to a class. Read XML and create JDOM with one shot. So I'm getting an element which represents one satellite. And this code definitely will work. So let's just use it in our test and see how it goes. So this is our transponder builder test. What I need to write? I need to write test which what it should do. This test should, let's think about first of small stuff. I need to check that my element which I got from my helper util isn't null. Check if JDOM satellite element not null. Basically, because I need to work with this element only then when it's not null. So I'm actually will work with boolean expected result is true, but the actual, what should be the actual result? Actual result should be determined by the call set transponder builder object. And here I'm making sure that I'm working with a JDOM document which have some contents, which is a satellite of some sort. So my set transponder builder object should verify set JDOM element. And I expect Now I can use my class. Now what I need to do? I need to read XML and create DOM with one set. Now I call it like this. And write here JDOM satLM new. I need to import. And now I need to pass this element to following, and of course I need to make my sort equals. And I need to make sure that I am doing the right stuff, checking if JDOM sat element is not null. So basically here I need to write my method, and I'm creating this method in Java here, I mean in my class, in Java class. So now I need to run it and have failing test first. Now I just need to run JUnit test. I have written a failing test. Now I need to fix it, and how I should fix it? Well, pretty obvious. So I'm read XML, create. No. It shouldn't go to my production code. Let me just delete it. What I need here, it should be for of the type of the JDOM element. Yeah, that's some sort of a problem, and of course I did mistake. Because I need to work with the JDOM element. Okay, so it is wrong. Let me just write here. This is not a JDOM. This is a helper mockup object, mock set element. This is right. Yeah, sometimes names matter. Most times the variables named meta, and I need to call the following stuff. Now I need to call read and set up JDOM document on it. And of course I need to throw some exception. And now I need to work it so in the way that I read this document, and I need to get hold of a method which gives me my satellite. So let me just do it like this. Okay, so now it expects from me a list of elements, because iterating over first level XML and look up for sat name. Did I need to look it up how my yeah. So basically expected list elements three elements, expected set element now, okay. Why have here two commas? Ah, it was some sort of confusing. So let me just figure out how I should call it this method. I need to have here classes. JDOM element, yeah, definitely I need it in my class. Set transponder. Here I should use it here. What just happened? Did not. Oh. Ah, okay. Now I have it too much. So, yeah. I need to make sure that I'm doing the right stuff. So. Set. So now. Now I need to do it here, and now what I actually need to do, I need to create two elements. One element it's kind of stuff which I don't like it to do, but I need to do it anyway. Now I need to look up this method, and I need to look up his signature. So it needs a list of elements, which is a list of satellites. Alright, so this list of satellites, where I'm getting this from? I'm getting this list of satellites. I'm actually don't need this. I don't need to call it that way, because my read up and set sub JDOM document already finds out what I need. I'm calling my check up. Wait a second. Alright, so here, read JDOM document. I need to call this method. I don't need this because it confused me. Yeah, it's confusing as hell. So I need one element which is represents our satellite. Element which represents our satellite JDOM element. Okay, and here, because read and set up JDOM document, it has no value, but read JDOM document and create first level list. I need to call following. This I call this. And now I can assign it. Now it should work. And why don't I need to finish it. Need to finish it like this. So where is the problem? Don't I use it in my class? Let me just. Yeah, I have broke my class. Helper mockup set element. I think I have it. Create. That can be. Oh, now it works. Yeah, it was a little bit confusing, but now it's not. And here I'm. Let me just do it in a safer way. Let me just do it here. Now I need to use it. I need to use it and. So basically, I'm passing my JDOM document. And. What it does not. So this element should be of type of JDOM document, should be JDOM element. Alright, finally. Now let's check it out. So if I got a satellite, let me just do it following. Now I need to get hold of this element. Did I misspell satellite? I'm actually thinking about it and it's misspell it. So basically it was a little bit confusing for me. Yeah, this is what you get when you work with helper methods, helper classes, throwaway classes. So satellite I need to write with one T. It's sometimes not fun, and I need one T. So basically, one T. And let me just do such stuff so you can read it. I know it's not good style, but what you get is what you get. Now you can read it. And now I can work with this method, verify set JDOM element. So I got my JDOM element and I need to make sure that this JDOM element, let me just write some values here, boolean. I don't need it actually. I think has is appropriate one. Has attributes. Indicate whether this element has any attributes. And I expect true from this true, then I return true, else I need to make sure that I return false. Pretty obvious stuff. I'm asking this element, do you have some attributes? And if you have some attributes, then I should continue my work, because why should I work when it has no elements? So it's safety, precautions to make sure that is not null. Let's just run my test and hope it works. I hope it works. Yeah, it works. So I'm getting my satellite. I'm actually getting my satellite. This is fun. This is really fun. So what should I check next? I know that I'm getting my satellite, and this is not now. So this is done, this part is done. I'm getting hold of a JDOM document, and then I need to get hold of a transponders to check the attribute. If the attribute need to assign them to transponder class object and transponder object to transponder list. So basically from this point my set transponders builder should finally build some stuff. And I'm just quite puzzled how I proceed further. So I'm getting the JDOM document, and I know that it's not null. Now I can work with it. Now I need to iterate over my, let me just look it up, my previous stuff. So here, I need to look up previous builder here. Okay, so I'm thinking about doing the same stuff. But yeah, let's just do this stuff. So let me just quickly run all of my tests to make sure that I have no failing test. Yeah, okay, so now I will write my builder test, basically. Void check. So what should I check? Well, I need to check that I can create a list of transponders for a given satellite, and that's it. That's all what my set transponders builder class shall do, nothing more. So check if transponders list can be built. Build. Okay, so now, and I expect at the end to get a boolean value which is expected result is true, and let me just do it as follows. So I call my helper object to get hold of a JDOM document, and here I'm doing the try and catch, basically the same the same stuff. Let me just copy the code. Now here I need to be able set up JDOM document now setting up my JDOM document and sure I can reuse this code, I mean to use it in my SATA for my JUnit, but I don't need this for this case. So let me just quickly write some stuff, and here I am writing the stuff and checking if transponder list checking if transponder list can be created. Transponders, I have many transponders, so now let me just do some stuff here. So yeah, boolean actual result, and I need to call my setTransponders builder object. Which should give me some boolean value at the end. SetTransponders builder object. And what I'm actually trying to do, I need to pass my JDOM document. Here my satellite element, so I need to pass my helper JDOM document exactly, and here I need just to write build transponder set list from the given JDOM element. And basically now I have created a failing test for my build transponder set list. Pretty obvious, but let me say following. When I create my transponder list, I check the attributes of my transponder and I create a list of CTV channels. Remember which I have done previously. This all should now take a place. Now this should be quite amazing stuff, because I need to write my method here. Now it should fail. Yep, it did fail. I expect true, but actual was false. And basically the stuff which I need to take care of is in the builder process. So let me just quickly look up. So, and basically I need to look up my set model just to understand how I process JDOM document. Second level. Okay. Because now I need to write some stuff. A lot of stuff. Yeah. Okay, so now I have an example how to do that. I need to go back to my method. So, and of course Eclipse done bad job because I need element and I don't need to include my helper class. I don't need this because it is not the right way to do the stuff. I need to get the element, which is a, it represents one satellite JDOM element, JDOM element. So it represents only one satellite. And now I just need to do what? I need to iterate over transponder. Actually, let me just think it through. So actually, I don't need to use boolean. Yeah, it wasn't not. This class, I expect actually to get a list of, and I expect to get actually list of my set transponder list here. And I need to rewrite my method. Yeah, I need to do this in some sort of another way. I get the list of my set transponder. Now list of transponders, new linked list of trans, let me just write it right, set I hope it goes well. Right, so here I'm just doing the proper stuff. Let me just quickly save it. Method build from request missing type list. No, I don't think so. Okay, so I need to import. Yeah, now I have the right import. Let me just quickly do some stuff here. Now it's alright, so, and the actual should be boolean. I need to refactor my test. Now it works. Here in the if I ask my list of transponders, which is a list of set transponder. And I'm asking, do you have some elements in your list? And if it is the case, then actual result is true. In other case, it will stay as false. Now I have proper, I have written proper test. Yeah, something stuff like this. But now I can write my set build transponder set list. Now where I have it? Set transponder builder. Let me just go to my set transponder builder class. So here I'm building my transponder list, and this should go like this. First, I need to get hold of all of my transponder elements. And let me quickly go over examples. Do I have here? Here I have an example. So basically, wait a second, set model, yeah. So here I'm getting one level deep into set. And here is exactly the same stuff. Here I need to write following. Where is my one level deep? So here I'm iterating over satellites. Now I'm just thinking about need to look it up my JDOM, yeah, prototype. Sometimes I forget the structure. So once again, I just show you a class from another project, which just iterate over the list. Yeah. So basically, okay, so I need to get a transponder, so I'm just looking for this type of stuff, I can reuse it. So here I have my transponder, and two levels deep, and this is actually represents the stuff which I got. Here I have my services and one level, two level deep. So and now I need to iterate over the two levels deep. Basically, actually, I can use the same type of iteration. Let me just. So you see, sometimes you need to have some sort of a prototype, because in the prototype you can see obvious stuff. So one level deep. Okay, so it's always the same, almost the same stuff. element which it represents two, which actually represents a transponder. Transpond, let me just write it like this, set transponder elem, which represents set transponder elem, and it getting from this. So I got my satellite, one satellite shade of element, I think I forgot to write here four. Yeah, sorry guys. And now let me just do following. I got my set transponder element from two levels deep. It's actually not two levels deep, it represents my transponder, all of my transponders elements. Rename it, let's make it obvious. Transponder elements for one satellite, for one set. Now it's obvious. And sometimes, as I said earlier, naming conventions always critical. Now what I need to do, I need to iterate over this. Over this list. And basically, I said earlier, a builder just builds a list of transponders. I don't need this iterator no more. All the stuff I don't need it. And here just. So basically, I need to create a list of set transponders. And now I need to think about how I proceed further. So I got my transponder it's some sort of a complex stuff which I'm thinking about, but it's actually easy one. Okay, so the transponder, let me just look at the services XML. The transponder have an ID and on it two stuff. And here I need to, first of all, I need actually set transponder, set transponder object new. Do I need to have a new? I just need to declare it. I just need to declare it, initialize it in later when I. So basically, what I should read first? This is what the question which burning me. What should I read first? And the example which I got from my parser, I'm getting the attributes and assigning them, and that's it. So let me just quickly go through my list. Let me just... So basically my problem why I didn't written code yet, I need to make sure that I am assigning right values. So let's just do it. Let's just do it. And let's just obtain the value. Transponder inversion. So basically, now I need to think about the stuff. So I have here getter, setter, getter and setter. I need to move it. Now I need to getter and setter. Yeah. And let me just move this method. And put it at the start. Like this. Now I need to save it. Yeah. This space and so now I just doing some pretty stuff, and here it goes like this. I need to validate inversion. So I just need to write here following this. And now I just write here validate inversion. And inversion gets a value, which represents an attribute of the set transponder element. Get attribute, and what should it be? Now it should be inversion. And we know that inversion is that get attribute returns string back. Now let me just quickly think of it. So byte parse byte, and sometimes it's parse by, what do you parse by? The method parse by string, but get attribute returns a string. Let me just quickly look it up. Maybe I did read some stuff. Get attribute value. Ah, okay. Now I got it. Actually, I need get attribute value. Yeah. Sometimes things happen. So now I assign this value to my builder class. I'm validating that I'm getting right inversion, and I just write next thing which I need to validate, which is validate fact inner. And here I just need to do almost the same stuff. Now here of course I need to use proper attribute name. So I'm validating spawner element get attribute. Now I just need to close it. Now okay, it looks not so bad. Yeah, maybe I should do it like this because that it shouldn't be such convoluted stuff. I hope it's clear what I'm doing. I will refactor this code. Later. And just need to write some stuff to pass my test. So here I'm validating and I need to call another validator. And now I need to validate inversion, and I need to validate my fact inner. Yeah, fact inner, and here the last one. So inversion, fact inner, and polarization. So where is the polarization? Polarization, validate polarization. And now I just need to validate my polarization like this. So I think this is almost the same type of code. Let me just write it here like this. And instead of fucking out right here, if right in this place like polarization. Now remember, always when I validate the stuff, I setting up my variables at my set transpose builder, so all this variables are already primed. Now it looks kind of ugly, but as I said earlier, I just need to pass my test right now because I have a failing test and I need to pass my test. So here free stuff has been validated, and I need to assign them to two. Before I do the assignment, I need to get hold of another things. The set transponder object, should I now create my set transponder object? When I create my transponder object, it expects some values, and then it will get even more crowded. Sure thing. And of course this is not enough, because for each of my transponder I expect to create a class of my I'm actually expecting. I need to call another builder. The TV channel builder. So I need to. Yeah, it's complicated, man. It's complicated. Now, I got my free attributes from transponder, and this is not enough. I need to actually get hold of other values. And I'm thinking about they're actually local type. So let me just copy these values from my setTransponder class. So all of these values should be now here. It doesn't matter, it's local values which I need to use. Let me populate integer with the zeros like this. Yeah, like this. Now it's the time to set up those values. And actually, I need to populate these values. So here I have checked values which I need always to check, and now I need to populate other things like transponder ID. The transponder ID should be populated with stuff which is, I think, but I have here transponder ID. Transponder ID is a string. So my job is easy for this type of value. Just do it like this, and transponder ID. And this is actually an ID of a transponder. ID. Now, the next step it will be. So I'm actually constructing the fields for this element. Transponder ID. Transponder on it. I'm calling this method get attribute value, and now I need to get an on it. I'm getting the on it. So what I need to get hold of, I need to get hold of transponder frequency, and I know it gets pretty crowded. Stay with me and you will see the result, and I just need to get it through. So here I need to, I think transponder frequency is an integer. Yeah, I need to write here things like integer parse integer, and here I need to, let me just think of it and close brackets. Get attribute. parse integer, and now I need to get hold of a frequency. Let me just do this in kind of understanding way. Okay, so now, yeah, I will definitely refactor this method which I have, because it's a big. I have many things to pass to my builder, to my constructor. So I did set up my inversion, pack inner, polarization, transponder ID, onit, frequency, and of course I need to do the same stuff with my transponder symbol rate. And I hope it does works well. And the funny thing will be with the channel list. Oh yeah, channel list will look pretty funny. Now I need to get hold of my symbol rate. Okay, so now I have another important milestone. I need to get hold of a list of my channels and pass it to my builder object. So first of all I need to write here that I got a list of CTV channels. That I'm getting the CTV channel list. This is what I'm getting. CTV channel list. And list CTV channel should be list of CTV channel per transponder, because each of the transponder have a list of CTV channels. And now I have it done so, and now I need to get hold of a builder object. So I have, let me just look at CTV channel builder. Yeah, and I need get hold of a set build CTV channels. Now I just need to switch back to my set transponder builder. Let me just CTV channel builder. Yeah, CTV channel builder. I will use it method later. CTV channel builder of CTV channel. Now I create this builder. I need this builder in order to build CTV channel list. Yeah, right. Okay, now basically here at the point I had inversion, fake inner, polarization. Inversion, fake inner, polarization. Fake inner, polarization, inversion. I do have these values. I need have onit frequency symbol rate ID. ID onit frequency symbol rate. And here I just need to pass, I need to get a list of get children. I think I need to use here get children of and go and get my list of the n elements. So let me just quickly look it up here. Set transponder elements, and now I need to call it up. Give me all get children of. Yeah, it's get crowded. I don't like it, and I will refactor it. Get children of, and now I can call. I think I should call. Wait a second. Should I call channel? Let me just think of. So basically, expected set element get children transponder. I'm just making sure that I understand what I'm doing. So each of elements. Wait a second. I'm working with a transponder, and he has. Ah, no, now I understand, yeah. Now I need just to write here channel. And this should be quite sufficient. So I'm getting list of elements which are channel, and I need to pass some value to. So let me just assign the value list of set TV channels. No, I need to do following. Here I am doing the assignment, but in the way that this command is a parameter for builder. Now it should be appropriate, and I should do it like this. And I know some people say, yeah, but what is the formatting? I cannot read this. I understand your concern. First of all, I need to pass my test, and then I refactor my code. I will repeat it once again. Now my list of things is complete, and now I can start actually. Now I can start actually assign all these values to my list. Actually can assign all of the values. So now what I need to do, I need to be able to create a new transponder. Let's just create first, create new set transponder, set transponder, I think this is the name of the, and I need to use set transponder constructor. Yeah, I have a crowded constructor here. And let's do this thing one for another. And then refactor it. So what I should do? I need to pass input set transponder ID. Here is my transponder ID. I need to pass my onit. Transponder frequency. Transponder inversion. Where I have my inversion? So now I need to be able get hold of this get, and I need my inversion, transponder inversion, symbol rate, symbol rate. Here is my symbol rate, and now I need my fake inner. Transponder fake inner. Fake inner probably the same stuff which I got here. This. Get fake inner. Transponder polarization, same stuff. This get polarization, yeah. Polarization, and here I need to get hold of a list of trans TV channels which I previously done. Okay, so now I need to add an input what I have here, string. Integer, string, byte, integer. Let me just do it again. And Yeah, it's convoluted, I know. So basically I need to make sure that I'm getting the right stuff in the right moment. String, integer, input transponder frequency is integer. On all of the things are pretty matched. 100% match. Input transponder ID. It is string. Transponder ID is string. So here is a string. Input on it. Transponder on it. Transponder frequency. Transponder frequency is matched by transponder. Okay, so it is input transponder inversion. This get transponder inversion. Integer input transponder symbol rate. Here's your symbol rate. I know it's almost at 2 hours. Yeah. But things like that happens that you work with such a large constructor. Input transponder fake inner. Fake inner, I have a fake inner too. This get my fake inner. And now I need to write it down. Input transponder polarization. This get polarization, and now I need just to get hold of a list. Let me just close it. Yeah, yoo-hoo! Now all of this stuff is a one transponder, which is should be assigned to so it expects I need to create a list of set transponders. So let's just give them this opportunity. I have a list. Set transponder transponder, which is a list of this is a list of transponders for one satellite. New linked list. Set transponder and just need to be do it done properly. Let me just do it like this and I hope yeah. And why I'm using linked list? Basically oops wrong now and using linked list for reasons because linked list is a sorted type of stuff, sorted type of data structure. But anyway, and now I need to assign this element. Now it goes like this: list transponder satellite, add the day. And now I can add this element. Yes. So I'm apologizing for doing such bad code, but this is only way to pass my test. So I creating finally. Finally, I am creating a transponder element which consists of transponder ID, ONIT, my transponder frequency. It consists of a get transponder inversion, transponder inversion, symbol rate, fake inner polarization, and transponder channel list. This is actually 8 values. Do I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8? So this should work, and my let me just close it, unneeded stuff. Let me just run my test. Set transponder builder. Where did lost my test? Ah, here it is, my test. No, it's Not the test, I need the test. The transponder builder test. Here is my, I have written, check if transponder list can be built. Now it's time to see the result. I forgot to return it. I was so excited, so I forgot to return my my result. So after doing all of this work, return, and I need to return. My list. Now it shouldn't fail. Basically, set transponder object. Set transponder. Ah, okay. So, set transponder. And actually, in all of my code, I actually don't need it. Yeah, I don't need to get hold of it. Yeah, doesn't matter here. Now let's save it. Let's close it. And now understand what just happened at the return statement, but no, it's actually list set transponder list. Let me just quickly use Eclipse help at the return statement. So it's basically Eclipse do not like it. Yeah. It should now. I just need to. Yeah. Eclipse. I think Eclipse have a problem with my things. Yeah. Broke Eclipse. Let me just delete it. Yeah, my mistake, I admit. And so now I need to run my test. Let me just run the test first. Yeah, did pass. Now, before I do refactoring and conclude my session, need to get some sort of output. Sys out. And what I should output. And I will output it only when I have some values. So it should output me list. String, and I hope this class that should give me some output, because I know set transponder have some values in the list. Let's just try it out and see that I got all things right. Okay. First question, for which of the satellite, but it looks good. I think it's rather search me channel transponder ID. It looks good. I think it's lot. It looks good because I see some values here. Service ID, service type. channel list. And I have here my frequency, transponder inversion, transponder polarization, and looks good. I'm pretty satisfied. Question only, the only one question is, from which type of the satellite do I get all of this stuff? In order to be able to, let me just close, I need to close all things about close others, yeah. Because I hate it when I always need to switch off. So I need to open my test, set transponder builder test. Now here I need to just, let me give it things like this. Now let me do this things like this, and now I need just to understand, yeah, I need to understand which satellite do I use so I can concentrate on checking it. And the satellite is Sirius Astra 5 EST. Let me just quickly go to it. Services. Now here I got this class. And let's check it. Let's actually check it if I got all of the values right. My test did show that I have, that I'm getting some result. That my list of transponders is not null, and it is very convenient. Now, let me just run this test. Once again, running my test. Let's go over, and let's just look it up. Let's just look it up where I have some values. So this transponder, wait a second, I need to clarify which of transponder do I actually use. Here, set transponder, and now I need just to get an ID, because now then I will know what type of a transponder, and I don't need to repeat it. I don't need to repeat this line exactly. So let me just run my test once again. Okay. And I forgot that I need to make sure which of the transponder. This transponder consists following this transponder with ID. And then I just need to mention the ID type. The transponder ID type. Let me just run it. The transponder builder test. That's this is the next one. Set transponder ID. It's showing me the next. Let me just quickly go to the transponder. So if I mention it second time, yeah, right. So I just need to delete this line. Okay. And delete this line. And I have here this line. and I basically to group it like I wish in the view. Let me just add, and now here I add the word contents channel list of channels in this transponder. Now I need to be able to make it breaker. Now I just need to make sure that I am using the right stuff. Right, so now it's all is as I expect, and it should work better. It should give better overview. But as I said earlier, if it runs, then it runs. If not, it does not. So, but I think it should. CTV channel name, CTV channel. Okay, so now I got better view. Now I just need to go over some. Yeah, I did promise to check it up from the list which I have. So basically, I need to find a value. Let me just find this value, and then we compare it. So I need to put my console like this, and basically look it up the value. So here you, for example, here you have. Let me just. Yeah. And I basically don't need this line. Basically, I need to do another correction of my set transponder output preview. I need to put in this line. I need to put. Let me just copy this line. Just do some stuff like this, and plus, and close it. Yeah. And of course, it need to be outputted in the right way. Now, I just need to get here to get to this line. So. Basically, now I get the proper output. Let's just run my test all again. And I'm just doing this to make sure that I'm getting the proper, that all of the data is not corrupted. And comparing to my services XML. Now, let's just do it like this. Yeah. So, I need to look up this value. So here you go. And basically, yeah, here you go. So I have here this transponder ID, which is 001E. Transponder ID 0056. Transponder on it. Frequency 11727 11727000. Transponder inversion 2. Symbol rate 2275 and 450s. And it looks good. Transponder polarization is 0, FEC inner 5, and this correspond to the channel list. You can clearly see that is the same values which I have ID and TV free sport service ID. Wait a second. Did I got something wrong? Let me just service ID. Okay. So TV free sport to service ID 0709. Yeah. So I got it through. I got my services XML saved up in the data. And now I just need to do some refactoring of my code, because it looks kind of ugly and unmaintainable. But I got it through. And what I actually need to do, I need to make sure that my console is. Let me just close it. And what I need to do, I need to set transponder builder here. So I don't need this because it's obvious. And here I just need to refactor this method, refactor extract method. I'm setting up and validate date inversion, fec inner and polarization right now. So here what I'm doing now, here I'm getting values of my stuff, and now I just need to refactor it. It tells me that it's not so quickly possible, but what I can actually do even better, I can make it sure that I'm doing like things like this extract method, and here I am actually converting value of frequency. Now it looks better, and now I'm doing here refactor extract method converting value of transponder symbol rate, and now I need to do this. Refactor extract method converting value of actually I'm not converting, I'm creating set TV channel list. So now I have here this funny constructor, and I can refactor it hopefully. Let me just do it following like right. Build set transponder set. So I hope it looks now some sort of a clean. This maximum star which I can do. And maybe I can. Maybe I can. Let me just think of it. Let me think here. Refactor struct method. Here I can write following. Add transponder to a transponder list. Okay, so it looks even better. Let me just do it things like this. And I hope it can work. I hope it works. I just need to do stuff like this. And now it's formatting issue, and yeah, but it I think it's the nature of the builder object. Now let me just run my test to make sure that I am doing that I don't broke anything. Set builder, where's my set transport builder test, and now I need to run this test. Yeah, so you see, basically I did refactor my code and nothing is broken, all pretty. Well, here I need to do to I does not matter. So now let me just conclude as follows. So when I run all of my tests, I shouldn't break anything. Run as my own test. And I was able to create this transponder list. Now I can create my satellite with a transponder, and this will basically, let me just, yeah, since 65 tests, only 3 skipped because of the output stuff. And yeah, pretty. And I am pretty satisfied with my work. And the stuff which I have got. Yeah. So yeah, I should mention that next step will be like following. Let me just conclude the stuff, and I need to add this element to my index. Add element to the index. Add to the index. And now I need to, the only thing is what I need to do is uncomment this output. Yeah. So where's my builder? Set transponder builder. I just need to uncomment. Where I have? Not here. Set transponder builder. Here. So here I just need to. And then basically, here I can uncomment here. Alright, so I need to save following. So my next move will be to create a set of services which represent satellite information with transponder, corresponding transponders list, and corresponding channel list. And after doing this, after creating said services set, I passing this to my model, and model just calls set service build, set service builder build, set service builder build. Yeah, I did spoke it right, right. And that's it. My set service model will consist of sets of sets services, which are satellites, and then that I can work with it. And then the only one job is to do, I mean, for the data structure, it will be model my buckets. And after I have done modeling with my buckets, I will basically will be able to start to do things like delete bucket, add bucket, insert bucket, delete bucket, insert bucket, find bucket, and things like working only with the buckets, buckets. Because after that, I will, after all of my crude operations with buckets complete, only after that I will start to work with JavaFX. But this groundwork is utmost importance for me, because when my data structure is clean and testable and covers all of the main functions which I have in mind, only then I can work with the GUI, and GUI is just adapter for me which use the underlying infrastructure. But that's it. Thank you for your time, and I wish you all the best. Bye bye till then.